Thank you very much. The day before COP started, Sunday 27th, we had a rally in the rugby stadium hosted by Archbishop Tutu, and we and both the president and the secretary of the UN and of COP17 attended, and we called on world leaders to put moral principles before self-interested financial considerations. We've said that climate change is a moral issue, and it must be met by the moral principles of justice, equity, compassion, love, and that we've got to really realize that we have got to put the well-being of the planet and people before our financial considerations. And we in Africa are particularly concerned because the scientists are now saying that African global average temperatures will increase twice as much as the global average. Already our temperatures have gone up 0.8, and we know the huge disruption of climate change already. If temperatures go up to 4 or 5 degrees, which is will happen if we just keep a 2-degree target, then it's going to be catastrophic. And I can only say it's immoral for nations to say, well, we are going to continue emitting carbon until a 2-degree average temperature. So we call upon all nations to say nobody, no country, is entitled to carbon space. Developed countries, the historic polluters, cannot justify continuing emitting carbon. We think it's immoral. And for the United States to say, well, we'll start reducing emissions in a few years' time, that's millions of tons of carbon that will still be poured into the atmosphere for the next 100 years. We can't bring that carbon back here. But we equally challenge the new polluting countries, China, India, ourselves, South Africa. We cannot claim that carbon space. But what we can claim is that the developed world can assist the developing countries, and I speak particularly for South Africa, sorry, for Africa, can assist us with technical cooperation and financial support that is owed to Africa to enable us to leapfrog the dirty fossil fuel era into the new solar and renewable energy era. Development is obviously important. It can be met through a clean new development, renewable energy development. And so we are saying to all nations, please recognize the reality of climate change. We are already severely impacted. And Archbishop Tutu at that rally said, come on, all people, all nations, and the planet are going to be suffering as we prepare the destruction, because that's what's happening to life as we know it on this planet. And so I think we've got to recognize that this climate change is a moral issue and must now be met with moral principles.